Hey everybody, and welcome back to Swift Lessons. Today, I'm once again honored to be joined by Stefany Mazor. How you doing?
I'm great. Thanks for having me.
Thank you for being here.
Thank you.
So what are we doing today?
We are going to be doing a cover of Shallow by Lady Gaga and Bradley Cooper.
Right, we're going to be doing a full cover of the song, and then I'm going to break it down for you step by step, and you can follow along using my tablature at patreon.com/swiftlessons. You ready to get started?
Let's do it.
All right,
one,
here we go.
1, 2, 3, 4. Tell me something, girl. Are you happy in this modern world? Or do you need more? Is there something else you're searching for? I'm falling. And in the good times, I feel myself longing for change. And in the bad times, I fear myself.
Tell me something, boy. Are you tired trying to fill that void? Keeping it so hardcore, I'm falling. And in the good times, I find myself longing for change. And in the bad times, I fear myself. I'm off the deep end, watch as I dive in. Crash through the surface where they can hurt us. We're far from the shallow now. In the shallow, shallow. In the shallow. In the shallow, shallow. We're far from the shallow now.
Okay, close look at the fretboard, getting started with our intro section. We're in the key of G, and we're going to be taking this line by line, following along using my tablature at patreon.com/swiftlessons. Your intro section is going to sound like this at a nice slow tempo. 1, 2, 3, 4. 2, 3, 4. All right, let's break that down. Okay, getting started with line number one. We're using standard Travis picking technique. Thumb controls the low strings, E, A, and D. And my index is designated to the G string, my middle finger to the B string, and my ring finger to the high E string. That's generally the approach that we're gonna be using in terms of finger choices on your picking hand, but there will be some exceptions to that. Okay, so getting started with line number one. Let's take it up to there, okay, that very catchy hook. We're gonna have an E minor 7 chord, 2nd fret of the A string, 2nd fret of the D string, and my pinky here on the 3rd fret of the B string. We're gonna pluck low E string, G string, B string, and then back to the G string. All right, the next chord is going to be a D slash F sharp. So it's just a D chord with your thumb wrapped around on the second fret of the low E string. And we're gonna play bass and then the G string and the B string together. Okay, so E string and then a double pluck before going to a G major chord, which we're gonna keep very simple. All right, just with my middle finger here on the third fret of the low E string and my ring finger here on the B string third fret. And we're doing a triple pluck. The low E string, G string, and B together. You put that together and we have our first measure of music. And something very recognizable. Let's try it one more time, real slow. Okay, and we're gonna hold that G major chord out for a full measure, four beats. Now, one thing I wanna mention about that G chord is that it's technically a G6 that's being implied, because occasionally throughout the song, you'll hear a little bit of random picking where the high E string is being included. But for the intro section, we're just gonna hit that triple pluck and let it ring out for the measure. Okay, from there, we're on to measure number three, C major. Sounds like this, get into your ear. Kind of an interesting time in, so let's listen to it one more time. Okay, so I take the C chord. I'm gonna play A, G, B, then take my pinky, put it on the third fret of the B string, and then go back to the G string. So far you have. All right, then from there, back to the A string, high E string, and then back to the B string with your pinky still down. Put all that together and we have. Okay, with the count, one and two and three and four and, just with the eighth notes there. Okay, you put all that together and we have line number one of your tablature. One, two, three, four. Two, three, four, C. Okay, very good. Now jumping into line number two, first a demonstration coming out of that C major chord that we just left off with. A one, two, three, four, and one, and two, and three, and four, and G. All right, so from the G major chord, we're gonna play. Let's get that first measure down because we have that really cool D major lick. So I grab my G major chord. I'm gonna have the low E string, then the double pluck, G and B together. And keep in mind that if you're playing the G major chord, you can have that index finger down on the first fret of the A string just for safekeeping. All right, then go to a D major chord and grab the D string, G string, and B string together. All right, now here's your lick. One more time. Okay, so I'm doing a hammer pull, 0-2-0 on the high E string. All right, that takes a little bit of practice. Remember, you gotta pluck the string as you're pulling down to get a nice pull off. All right, then go to the B string, and then to the G string, and if you get a little bit of the D string on this last pluck, that'll sound a little bit more accurate to the track. Okay, practice that nice and slow. It's just one of those things that kind of comes together over time. All right, so the G chord, D chord, and then lick. All right, from there, we're basically just going to repeat what we did in measure number one. Let that G major chord ring out for a full measure to get you into the verse section, which is going to include a lot of the same techniques as this intro, just with a few variations. Okay, very good everybody. You have that intro section down. Now we're moving into the verse section. As I mentioned before, it's gonna be a lot of repetition. So we're starting off the exact same way with the E minor chord. Two, three, four. Then we're gonna get to the C major chord, but it's gonna be a different pattern. It's gonna sound like this. Okay, with the count, one and two and three. So I'm plucking A string, G string, B string, back to the G string, then back to the A string, B string, G string, and D string. Now, throughout the song, there's a lot of different variations over this particular chord, the C major. But this is representative of the track, and it's taken out of the Lady Gaga section of the tune. Okay, from there, we're gonna go to the G major chord. This is nothing new. The G, the bass, the double pluck, and then a triple pluck over the D major chord. Now, in the intro section, after that, we had that nice little hammer-on pull-off lick. We're gonna do it again, but we're gonna play it a little bit later, and we're gonna shorten it just a hair. It's just gonna be the 0-2-0 with the hammer and pull, and then to the B string. Okay, and the phrasing is gonna be specific. It's gonna sound like this, real slow. One more time. Okay, put all that together and we have line number one of our verse section. One, two, three, four. Two, three, four, and one, and two, and three, and four, and one, and two, and three, and... Okay, now, on to the next line of tablature. It's just going to be a repetition of that E minor, D slash F, G change. Let it ring, and then repeat. Okay, very good everybody. You have the intro, now you have the verse section complete. Remember, that verse section is going to be repeated four times through, and then we're going to have just that kind of main riff of the tune repeated twice as kind of a connector between the two verses, the one that Bradley Cooper sings and the one that Lady Gaga sings. So if you have those sections down, then you're ready to move into the first chorus. We're gonna be dividing this into two sections, chorus 1A and chorus 1B, and they're both going to repeat two times. It's gonna sound like this, chorus 1A. One, two, three, four, and... Okay, let's break that down. Okay, so chorus 1A is gonna start off with an A minor chord. We're gonna do an arpeggio with the thumb. That was A, D, and G. And then a double pluck, B string and high E string. All right, then we're gonna do a hammer pull. That was the B string, 0-1-0. Now I'm back to my typical kind of Travis picking technique there that we mentioned before. So, middle finger on the B string for that hammer pull. Then the G string and the D string, my index finger and my thumb. Okay, put that together and we have real slow. Okay, as Lady Gaga sings, I'm off the deep end. All right, from there we're on to D slash F sharp for measure two of this section. Okay, so low E string, G string, B string, high E string, take the middle finger off, now open E string, B string, and G string. So far you have. All right, now we're going to the G major chord. All right, that was E string, G string, B string, and then G string. And we're gonna repeat that pattern again. On a D slash F sharp. All right, and then finally, we're gonna end this section with an E minor 7 chord. All right, that was E, D, B, G, B, G, D. Okay, you put those four measures together and we have chorus 1A. Sounds like this real slow. See if you can play along. It may take you a few repetitions. Now moving on to chorus 1B, this is the section where they're singing. In the shallow, in the shallow, or something along those lines, right? Okay, so this is going to be very similar to what we just played, but slightly different rhythm and some different movements. We're starting off with the first measure here. Okay, so I have the A minor chord. A, G, B, E. Take my pinky, put it on the G note, third fret, low E string. And then play B and high E string with that A minor down. Okay, put that together. Okay, then to the D/F# chord. Very simple, just E, G, B, E, B, G. Okay, put those two measures together and we've got. Okay, now onto the G major chord to D/F# change. This is familiar. Okay, so we've already played that before. E, G, B, G, E, B, G, B on those two chords. Then onto the E minor 7 chord for that familiar pattern. Okay, just what we did before over the E minor 7. So that will repeat once through. Then on the second repetition, we're going to double the E minor 7 chord to get us into the bridge section. So. Okay, that's when the song's really gonna hit the roof and we're going to see Lady Gaga really show off her vocal prowess. And big props to Stefany Mazor for tackling this section. Okay, very well done everybody. You have your intro, you have your verse, and your first chorus sections down. Now we're moving into the bridge section where we're gonna start strumming. It's gonna sound like this at a nice slow tempo. 1, 2, 3, 4. Get you into the second chorus where we're going to be strumming. Okay, so this part is very simple. We're just playing some chords here. We've got a B minor chord shape. All right, this is the first bar chord that we've played, so we're barring the second fret, setting up our minor shape, fourth fret of the D, G, and third fret of the B string. Okay, we're going to have that for a measure, and there's a lot of different ways that you can strum this. You might want to do a little palm muting. But generally speaking, we're just going to be going down, 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 down. Okay, we'll move to the D major chord and do the same thing. Over the A major chord, I'll count it this time. 1, 2, 3, 4, and. So emphasis on 2 and 4. Then, we're gonna go to an E minor chord. You could play E minor 7, but for my arrangement, I'm gonna just opt for plain E minor chord. Just to add some contrast. Same exact strumming. 1, 2, 3, 4, and. Put that together and we've got line 1 of your bridge section. 1, 2, 3, 4, and. 1, 2, 3, 4, and. 1, 2, 3, 4, E minor. Then line number 2, we're going to B minor again. 1, 2, 3, 4, and. 1, 2, the D major chord. And then A major chord to finish it up. All right, that will get you into an A minor chord to start your next chorus section. Okay, beautifully done everybody. We're almost through the entire song. We just gotta get through the last chorus to end the tune. So, after the bridge, we're gonna jump into chorus 2A. It's gonna sound like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, A minor. 2, 3, D/F#. 2, 3, and G, D/F, and E minor, A minor, D/F, and G, D/F, E minor. Okay, so very, very simple. Measure of A minor, just letting it ring out. 2, 3, 4, the D/F, 2, 3, 4, the G. D/F, and then the E minor chord. Do one long stroke, and then chug. That's going to be kind of an introduction to a strumming pattern, the calypso pattern. Down, down, up, up, down, up, over A minor. D/F#, and then we're gonna cut the pattern for two chords. G major, down, down, up, and then the D/F#, down, down, up. Okay. So far you have on line 2 of this chorus. Down, down, up, down, down, up, and then the E minor chord. So a much easier approach to playing the chorus than we had in chorus number one. Okay, so that's all of chorus 2A. Let's put it together now. A 1, 2, 3, A minor.
I'm off the deep end.
The G. D. E minor. A minor. Down, up. Up, down, a D. Down, up. Up, down, a G. Down, a D. Down, a E minor. Okay, now on to chorus 2B to finish up the tune. This part's going to be very simple as well, just strumming. The A minor chord gets us started. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then repeat that. Play an E minor chord with a slow stroke to end the tune. Okay, so this part, we're just playing the A minor chord, down, down, up, hit the bass note, G, and then down, up. Okay, then from there, it's going to be basically business as usual. The D slash F sharp chord, down, down, up, up, down, up. The same thing that we did before over G major to D slash F sharp. Before going to the E minor chord, down, down, up, up, down, up. And we'll repeat that twice. So, the second repetition, let's see if we can do it together. The G, the D, and E minor, and then end the tune, just like that. Congratulations, everybody, you're ready to perform. Alright friends, thanks so much for checking out this lesson on Shallow. I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know what you think in the comment section down below. And be sure to give a shout out to Stefany Mazor for lending her vocals. She did an amazing job, and we'll be sure to have her back here soon. I also want to thank my patrons. Thanks so much for making these lessons possible. Thanks to you guys, I got many more lessons coming up. So keep checking in. Please subscribe, please share. This is Rob at Swift Guitar Lessons in Philadelphia, saying happy picking.